Hi, it's Dave. So I'm excited about Tesla's AI plans and their Optimus humanoid robot in development. And you might expect me to think it would have a positive impact on Tesla's stock price, but this might not be the case, or at least in the near term. And I think it's important to understand why Wall Street doesn't like the AI robot right now. So this morning, I was reading an article about Andre Karpathy on his LinkedIn. He posted kind of a post about some job openings, and he had some comments about AI and what Tesla is doing. He says, there's no other organization that vertically integrates, develops, and deploys cutting-edge robotics AI at this scale. Our goal is to improve the safety and comfort of driving along the way to automating transportation with full self-driving. We are also applying everything we've learned to our humanoid robot TeslaBot, which I believe is on track to become the most powerful AI development platform. All right, I want to take a look at a couple slides of what an S-curve looks like. So if you see this red line, it's the S-curve. It starts out very kind of shallow, and then it goes into a very steep slope up, and then it becomes more gradual afterwards. Now, the thing about this S-curve is that initially it doesn't look like it's much until it hits an inflection point, and then it just goes right near vertical and it really surprises people. A few observations from this website, innospective.net. So first, things go very slowly, then they go really fast, and then they slow down quite suddenly. This is about the S-curve. Why is it so hard to intuitively grasp this? Humans are really bad at understanding nonlinear growth. The main reason probably that we're used to fairly linear growth in nature. So if you look at this graph, it's kind of linear. The growth path is almost exactly a straight line after a quick initial growth spurt. Most organic life forms follow this kind of near linear, very gradual growth. We intuitively expect new things to first grow quite quickly before settling in on a constant linear growth path. At the bottom of the S-curve, it feels like not much is happening at all. Once you cross an inflection point, suddenly things start going wild. All right, what's going on here? So a few things. First, Andre Karpathy thinks that the TeslaBot could be the greatest AI platform in the world. And he says it's actually on track to do that, which is, I think, hugely bullish. I think AI is going to be the biggest technological trend in our generation, and it's going to be worth tens of trillions of dollars, if not more. So Tesla doubling down on the future of AI is bullish for Tesla's share price, right? Well, not exactly. And this is why I showed a few slides on the S-curve of technology. You see, AI robots are like basically other technology things as well. It takes a while to hit that S-curve inflection point, and it could actually take quite a while in this case. For most Wall Street investors, they can't give any value to this until they really see it take off. And then when it takes off, they'll kind of always be behind the S-curve until it tapers off. And most of Wall Street is actually completely fine with that. See, lots of investors, they want certainty and less risk, not more. It's okay if AI robots are a side project for Tesla, but they don't really want Tesla talking or focusing on it too much, because if it becomes a focus, it's so uncertain and it brings more risk into other parts of the business. It reminds Wall Street of some crazy man at the helm wasting money on an endless pit of pet projects. Wall Street typically likes predictability, and they want to focus on the next 1 to 2 years. If you talk about things 5 to 10 years out in the future, lots of institutional investors are simply not interested. Portfolio managers, they care about this year's performance. And for them, the TeslaBot doesn't help this year's performance. It only poses risk. And I think if Elon focuses on the TeslaBot more and more, a few things are likely to happen. First, really long-term focused investors will eat it up and they'll see huge value in it. But there will be a growing divergence of beliefs. More short-term focused investors will hate it and will want Tesla to focus just on cars and their current business. The second thing, the more Elon focuses on the bot, I think the more people will realize how far off it really is in terms of really becoming a substantial part of Tesla's revenue and profits. It just takes a long time to get to that inflection point on the S-curve. So people can see Elon as just pumping things. They will call him a charlatan, fraud, etc. And it'll be another rallying point for skeptics and shorts. Third, I think it's likely that we will see sell on the bot events, meaning it's possible some investors will see an opportunity to sell or reduce their Tesla exposure during events or times when the bot is featured, like at a Tesla event or at the earnings call that we just saw last week, or let's say at a prototype reveal. In other words, the bot presents more near-term uncertainty and risk for an uncertain long-term future, and that's not what a good amount of investors want to see. It's ironic, but completely understandable. You see, the typical investment world is more about certainty, predictability, and preservation of assets. Shooting for the stars or going after some crazy robot feature actually turns a lot of investors off. That is until they can see it show up in the income statement, and that's going to be quite a ways off. So am I bearish on Tesla stock price over the next couple of years because of the Tesla bot? No, because I think it's likely going to be outweighed by a bigger force. Tesla currently appears to be going through an inflection point on the S-curve with electric vehicles. They're experiencing off-the-charts demand for their cars, and they're riding the steep part of the S-curve right now. This could be very, very bullish for Tesla stock, as most investors underestimate the slope of the S-curve when it starts sloping up. It's also unique that Tesla is going through this phase while being profitable and becoming increasingly profitable. You see, most companies go through this S-curve and the inflection point while pouring everything back into the business and often taking losses. Another bullish thing is that this steep part of the S-curve for electric vehicles and also for autonomous cars and vehicles will take many, many years to play out. Making cars is a slow process to scale. It's not like software. So all of this just makes this S-curve inflection point that Tesla is in, this steep kind of slope that Tesla is going to experience in the next several years, all the more juicy and potentially lucrative. All right, I hope this has been helpful. If it has, go ahead, like, and subscribe. All my videos can be found as an audio podcast as well. Just search for Dave Lee on investing in your favorite podcast player. All right, I'm also on Twitter at HeyDave7. We'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks.